Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you varieties of timers in TCP. Before we start with the video, let me show you how many things that I'm going to cover in this video. See, first I'll explain you how time wait timer is there in TCP. Secondly, I'll explain you how persistent timer that is there in TCP. Then I'll explain you how keep alive timer that is there in TCP. Then I'll explain you how acknowledgement timer that is there in TCP, and at last I'll explain you how timeout timer that is there in TCP. So I'll explain you all these timers along with practical examples that will give you more clarity regarding how exactly all those timers are functioning in TCP. Let us see first how time wait timer is there. See here, when you talk about time wait timer, then that is what we are using it for. Delayed segments received by receiver. See, in computer network, there is always possibility that some segments may be received by receiver with some delay. It is not like every time with finite duration only segments will get received, right? Sometimes those packets may get delayed because of some reason. There may be a congestion in the network, or there may be routers, those are very busy for data transfer, right? So sometimes that happens, like segments are received by some delay. And to tackle all those issues regarding delayed received segments, here we are having time wait timer, right? And that will tackle those issues which is there regarding delayed received segments. There is second timer, that is persistent timer. Now when we talk about persistent timer, then that I have already explained in my last videos based on flow control of TCP. I have told you persistent timer, that is what we are using it for flow control. Let me show you that again. See, in flow control, I have explained you, we are dealt with to control the flow in between two hosts. Here, let us assume H1 is transmitting data to H2. Here H1 is very fast in terms of data transmission. Let us say H1 is having higher bandwidth than the bandwidth which is there with H2. So obviously H1 will be forwarding data with higher rate. So what happens here is, here you see data received by receiver will make window full over here at receiver side. The reason is sender is sending data with higher rate, and as if data transmission is with faster rate, in that case at receiver side there is always possibility that window will get full. As if window is getting full, then obviously receiver cannot receive data, right? So there is no point of sending data by sender. So what receiver will do is, receiver will give acknowledgement. In that acknowledgement it will say my window is full. How? By saying window size is equals to 0 byte. Window size is equals to 0 byte means right now there is no space in my window, so there is no point of sending data right now. So as if this acknowledgement that is received by sender, then it will stop sending the data. It will start with persistent timer. So after persistent timer, again it can start data transmission, right? And how it can start data transmission, for that you need to go through my video based on flow control. Right now you just understand this. See, this persistent timer that we are using for flow control, if receiver window is full, then receiver will inform sender by saying that receiver window size is 0 byte. Then sender will wait by persistent timer for further data transmission, right? So for flow control we are using persistent timer. Now let me explain you how we have keep alive timer. See, this is quite interesting. Keep alive timer, that we use it for closing the idle connection. Let me explain you that by one practical example. Practically, when you talk about client server network, at that time we are having this type of timer. Like here you can observe we are having one server. With this server, so many clients are connected. It is always possible some clients may go idle. Like see this C1, let us say C1 is asking for request with server. So right now connection is active, but for some reason, let us say C1 is idle. So this connection is idle right now. As if connection is idle, then for server, it will be very difficult to give services to all the clients. See, as if clients are going idle and as if server is connected with all the clients, then do you think like server can give services to all the clients? Obviously no. Why? The reason is server is having limited RAM, server is having limited computational complexity, like limited capacity of CPU. So RAM, CPU, all those things that is required at server side. So at server side, it is very essential. It should terminate the idle connection. And for that, keep alive timer that is used. Let me show you how we are using it. See, right now, let us assume this client is sending packet to server, right? So server will be ticking keep alive timer, right? See, right now over here, after this packet, again, it will be having keep alive timer. As if it is receiving another packet, then it will be resetting that keep alive timer. And right now you see there is no packet that is forwarded by client to server. So this keep alive timer that is getting ticking on continuously. After some time, this keep alive timer that is getting timeout. Once it is getting timeout, this server will be sending probe frames, right? Practically, if I tell you, typically we will be forwarding around 10 probe frames, right? But that depends even how format is there and how that is getting programmed over here. So that depends, but probe frames that is getting forwarded by server to client. And see, this probe frames that is saying like, are you alive or not? If this client is not interested, then after some time, server will initiate close connection. And how to have close connection in TCP, that I have already explained, right? For that, you need to have 4 frames transmission by which this server can terminate this connection. And as if server is terminating this connection with close connection in TCP, then server can utilize its RAM, its CPU to give services to other clients. So here, keep alive timer that is used to close idle connection. Now let me explain you another timer, that is acknowledgement timer in TCP. See, TCP is sending cumulative acknowledgement after acknowledgement timers times out. You see how here sender is sending data to destination. So here you see, after reception of first packet, this destination is initiating with acknowledgement timer. Here destination is receiving some packets. After some time, this acknowledgement timer that is getting timed out. So this destination will give cumulative acknowledgement of all these packets. See, this cumulative acknowledgement that is getting forwarded based on acknowledgement timer. Sometimes, as if this destination is forwarding data along with acknowledgement over here, in that case you can say this is piggybacked acknowledgement. The reason is TCP is not only about half duplex communication, TCP is all about full duplex communication, right? So as if this is about half duplex communication, in that case this will be simple acknowledgement. But if here destination is forwarding data along with acknowledgement, then you can say this is piggybacked cumulative acknowledgement. Cumulative means acknowledgement for all these packets along with data is forwarded. So cumulative plus piggybacked. Piggybacked, that comes as and when there is data along with acknowledgement. Remember this. So this is how acknowledgement timer that is there with TCP, that is for cumulative acknowledgement. And along with acknowledgement, as if data is there, that is referred as piggybacked acknowledgement, right? Now last timer, that is timeout timer. I have already explained you that in retransmission of TCP. See here, when sender is sending data to destination, at that time, once it forwards the packet, it will initiate with timeout timer. And for some reason, as if this packet is getting lost somewhere in the medium, or as if acknowledgement that is getting lost in the medium, in that case sender will never know like whether this packet is received by destination or not. So here sender is initiating with timeout timer with all the packets. After timeout, it will do retransmission of packet. So for retransmission, timeout timer that is there with TCP. Here, there are few things that you should know. See, value of timeout timer that is dynamically set based on network parameter. Like you will be observing at night time, network traffic is very less. So at that time, timeout timer that time will be less, right? But during daytime, all the humans are active on computer network, right? And because of that, what happens? There is always possibility that there may be a need of retransmission. But in that situation, this timeout timer, that value will be high. So during night time period, timeout timer that will be having lower value, and during daytime period, timeout time period that will be having higher value. How it is getting set? It is getting set dynamically. For that, I'm going to make separate video. So in future coming videos, you will be observing how to set dynamically, how to set timeout timer dynamically, right? I'll explain you that by algorithm that will give you more clarity. So this is all about timers and TCP. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.